Kritika, welcome back to my channel. Today we're exploring a destination that has captured the imagination of countless travelers, the United States. Whether you've dreamt of exploring the vibrant streets of New York City, the dazzling lights of Las Vegas, soaking up the sun in California, or marveling at the natural wonders of the many national parks there, there are some things you need to keep in mind if you're planning a trip to the US. I've been to the US 5 times now and traveled to 13 or 14 states, and in this video, I'll be sharing my top travel tips to make your trip to the US an unforgettable adventure. Some of these tips are also applicable for international travel in general, so keep on watching. First things first, let's talk about the US visa. It's a very useful visa for us Indians to have because not only does it let you travel to the US, but it also gives you access to tons of other countries like Mexico, Colombia, Costa Rica, the Philippines, Turkey, and so many others. So in a way, having the US visa is a good way for us with Indian passports to have some kind of passport privilege. And the good thing is that in most cases, if you're granted the visa, it's valid for 10 years, which is great. I got my US visa back in 2016 with a 10-year validity, and it's really come in handy over the years and is still valid for another 3 years. If you're visiting as a tourist, you'll have to apply for a B2 visitor visa. The process itself is quite straightforward, though it's a bit tedious. You will have to fill out the form DS-160, pay the US visa fee, which is around $160, schedule an appointment, arrange for all the documents required, submit your application at the US Visa Application Center, and go for the visa interview. At the end of the interview, you'll get to know whether or not you receive the visa. The downside in the post-pandemic times is that the wait time to get an application in India is over a year, which is a very long time. So if you're planning a trip, your best bet would be to start the visa process over a year in advance at least, and keep checking for earlier slots that may open up. I also know of people who've actually traveled to other countries to apply for the US visa, so that's something you can consider if you can afford it and if you're in a rush to get the visa. Also, be prepared for the visa interview. It can be quite intimidating, but if you're prepared, you should be fine. So familiarize yourself with the purpose of your travel, your itinerary, who you're going to be visiting, and be ready to answer questions related to your ties to your home country, India, and your intention to return after your visit. Next, let's talk about connectivity. When you visit the US, you'd want to stay connected with your friends and family back home in India. For me, I'm also working while traveling, so I need a reliable option to stay connected while I'm abroad, be it for making work calls or sharing content on the move. So I always prefer using international roaming on all my trips. A lot of people also consider getting local SIM cards, but I feel like international roaming just works way better for me since I get it activated on my own number and I don't have to think of changing or sharing new numbers with people. The last time I was traveling to the US, I had to make some bank transfers, and you don't always get reliable Wi-Fi everywhere, especially when you're on the move. Because I had Airtel international roaming activated, I got updates on my number and worked without any hassles, and you don't need multiple packs for this because one single pack is valid across 180 plus countries. Most flights I take end up having layovers, so with my roaming pack, it gets activated as soon as I land in the country of the layover, so I feel like I'm very well connected no matter where I travel to. And in case my trip gets postponed for whatever reason, the pack doesn't go to waste because it only gets activated when you actually arrive in a foreign country. You also get 24/7 customer support, which is very important to me personally, especially on my solo travels or when I'm in different time zones. A lot of times during my longer trips, I need to work on the go and also keep check on my business work, like, you know, filing my GST returns and things like that. Since I stay connected on my own number with roaming, I can get the necessary OTPs on my phone. So if you're also going abroad and have to make payments, you'll need to keep your Indian number active for OTPs. So it just makes sense to get international roaming. Last year, I actually had Airtel international roaming pack activated for 9 out of 12 months, and it just makes things so convenient. So I can't even imagine traveling without it, to be honest. And it's one of the travel hacks I live by. You can check out the packs. I've added a link in the description below and choose the one that fits you best. Now coming to planning your itinerary. Planning an itinerary for the US can be quite a daunting task because of how massive the US is. It's important to realize that you may not be able to see everything on your trip. I've spent about 5 to 6 months traveling in the US in total, and like I said, I've only traveled to like 13 or 14 states. So the best way to explore the US, in my opinion, is to go deep instead of going wide. Pick a region or two and spend time exploring it thoroughly and save other parts for a different trip. Usually when we travel from India to the US, we plan to visit the more popular and touristy places like the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco, Times Square in New York City, Las Vegas or the Niagara Falls, but the US is a massive country and has so much more to offer than that. If you're a nature lover, there are 63 national parks in the US and tons of state parks, and I definitely recommend visiting some of them on your trip, depending on which region you're visiting. During my first trip to the US, I visited Grand Canyon and it was so breathtaking and one of the highlights of that trip. On another trip, I visited the Mount Rainier National Park near Seattle. You may have seen that vlog on my channel, and again, it was just so mesmerizing and totally worth visiting. So depending on which part of the US you plan to visit, look up for national parks and state parks and try to add those to your itinerary as well. You can also search for festivals or cultural events happening during your visit to get a unique perspective on the local culture. You can also look for tours available on platforms like Get Your Guide or Airbnb experiences for each of the city you're visiting and plan your daily itinerary based on that. A lot of the activities include day trips to places where they also provide transportation. So it's a great way to see places if you don't want to drive there yourself. Speaking of transportation, some cities have decent public transportation. In major cities like New York City or San Francisco, you'll find extensive subway or bus networks. However, in most other places, renting a car might be the most convenient option. Just remember to familiarize yourself with local traffic rules and consider getting an international driving permit if required, because I think some of the states do require that. Now let's talk about some packing tips. Research the weather conditions of the places you'll be visiting in the US during your travel dates. This will help you pack appropriate clothing and accessories for the climate, whether it's hot and humid, cold and snowy, or somewhere in between. Since the US is a vast country, the weather actually changes quite frequently while you go from the East Coast to the West Coast, or from the North to the South, and sometimes even within a city like in San Francisco with its microclimates. So it's a good idea to carry layers instead of a big heavy jackets, which usually end up taking more space while packing. Expect to do a fair amount of walking while exploring cities or visiting tourist attractions, so be sure to pack comfortable shoes. You also have to carry travel adapters to charge your devices, as the US uses a different electrical plug compared to India. If you have any prescription medications, make sure to pack them in their original packaging and carry a copy of the prescription. In general, I think it's a good idea to carry some basic medicines, since it may be difficult to buy them without a prescription in the US. This actually happened with me on one of my trips. I fell sick and thankfully I was carrying antibiotics. Otherwise, I think the process to get it can be quite complicated and you may need to visit a local doctor to get a prescription. So save yourself all that hassle and carry some medicines. Speaking of falling sick, I always recommend getting travel insurance whenever you're traveling. In case you fall sick, lose your luggage in transit, or your trip gets cancelled for whatever reason, it's very helpful to have travel insurance to claim all those expenses. If you're in the US, I'm sure you'd want to do some shopping. A lot of items like electronics and even clothes and accessories for that matter are more affordable there than in India. But something to keep in mind is that most states will actually add an additional sales tax to the MRP, and this sales tax amount is different in each state. There are also some states that are tax-free, like Delaware, Alaska, and Oregon. So if you happen to visit any of those states, then plan to do all of your shopping there. The first time I visited the US, I bought a lot of Apple products and other electronics and did all of that shopping in Delaware, so I didn't end up having to pay any additional sales tax, and it was awesome. But even if you're not visiting any of these no sales tax states, research the sales tax rates in the states that you do plan to visit so that you can choose to shop in the state with the lowest sales tax. Also, every major city has outlet malls which have amazing discounts. So if you're planning to shop, definitely visit an outlet mall, and preferably in a low or no sales tax state. The US is honestly quite an expensive destination. The cost of a trip to the United States can vary depending on the duration of your stay, the cities you plan to visit, your accommodation choices, dining preferences, activities, and your overall travel style. But with careful planning and budgeting, it is possible to have an affordable trip to the United States, and I'm going to be sharing some of my tips with you. First, avoid traveling during the holiday season or public holidays, and if you are, then book everything way in advance. I actually spent Christmas in New York City back in 2021, and I booked a hotel for a couple of days in Manhattan, and the price was easily double of what it normally would have been. So in general, traveling during off-season is a good idea if you're on a budget. Second, look for budget hotels or affordable Airbnbs for your stay. There are some hotel chains that are in the budget category, and if you book in advance, you can actually get a good deal. Third, if you enjoy cooking and are on a budget, you can save a lot of money by cooking at least some of your meals. And if you plan to do that, then look for hotels and Airbnbs that actually have kitchens. Most major cities have city passes that cover a lot of the major attractions in the city, and it ends up being more cost effective than individually buying tickets for each attraction. So you can consider getting that. I did that in San Francisco. Also, many cities in the US offer free or low cost attractions, parks, museums, events. So take advantage of these opportunities. If you are renting a car, try to avoid renting from an on-airport rental agency, especially in the bigger cities. So you'll be better off taking an Uber or Lyft to your hotel and then booking a car through a rental agency in town, because I've heard they're a lot more affordable. When it comes to connectivity, I have found Airtel International Roaming to be more affordable than local SIMs in the US, with packs starting at just rupees 133 per day, so you could check that out. Don't waste your money buying water, because tap water is usually safe to have in the US. And if you do want to buy water, then do it at a 7-Eleven or a supermarket, because you'll get like a big water can for a couple of dollars and it's quite affordable. Now let's talk about the budget for a trip to the US. Like I said, the US can be quite an expensive place to travel to, and the budget for your trip will really depend on various factors like the duration of the trip, the destinations you plan to visit within the US, the level of comfort and luxury desired, and other personal preferences. So it's hard for me to give you a figure of how much you need, but I'm going to share some of the rough costs just to give you an idea. If you're planning to do a super budget trip, you can easily bring these costs down, and if you're planning to do a more luxurious trip, these costs will go up. So firstly, a round trip flight from India to the US on average is around 80,000 rupees to 1 lakh. Again, depends on so many factors, but I'm just sharing an average cost with you. For accommodation, it really depends on where you're staying and which time of the year you'll be visiting, but you'll easily spend at least 15,000 to 20,000 rupees per night on accommodation. For food, you'll probably spend at least 2,000 rupees per meal. If you're eating out, it is quite expensive, but the portion sizes in the US are huge, so you can always get the food packed and eat it later as well, or share your meals with your friends. For transportation, if you're renting a car, it can cost from $50 to $100 a day and extra for fuel. Public transport in cities that do offer that will probably be $3 to $5 per ride, and obviously if you choose to take cabs everywhere, the cost can really add up. You'll probably spend around $20 to $100 per day on attractions, depending on what you're doing. So I hope this gives you a rough idea of the costs in the US. You can look up prices online for your specific dates and itinerary and plan your budget accordingly. The US has a big tipping culture, so in general, you're expected to tip around 15 to 20% at restaurants, to hotel staff, to your Uber drivers and other service providers. It does feel like a lot when you convert the amount to rupees, but this is just the norm in the US and something you should follow, except of course if you had a really bad experience somewhere. Typically, servers make most of their income through tips, and even though it's a voluntary thing, you're kind of expected to tip people. So yeah, keep that in mind as well. And that wraps up my travel tips for your adventure to the US. I hope you found these tips useful and insightful, and if you have any questions, feel free to comment them down below. If you have any tips from your personal experiences, I'd love to read them as well, so comment those too. And I'll also leave a card here if you want to check out my vlogs from the US, and as always, stay tuned for more exciting travel content coming your way. Bye!